doing today? Those of you who have made it into the stream at this point. And why don't we just go ahead and get this handled here quickly. Started the 89 quest. Up some funds here so I could finish getting my 90 gear. At which point I would have level 90 gear equipped. All high quality, all useful. Anymore. did not have access to here until just now, but it's still 81 enemies. Bring him here as a child. Prove yourself worthy of their trust, dude. Hamlet is where I want to go. Like ASAP. So before I go that way, this way to the Hamlet. Because I want to attune to the safety, right? Since we're allowed to come and go from this level in this area as we please. be able to just immediately go attune to the etherite. Skywatcher isn't important. Just see what the weather is. Tune to the Aetherite. The way I came in order to get back to where I need to be. See what is in that direction, but it is of no importance currently, so I'm not going to. Alright. Down. These enemies are level 88. Alright.
I could swap them out.
No, been there, done that. Down there, lost my eyebrows.
Think, Kogel, think! We'd be well on our way to paradise. Visionaries patting themselves on the backs for their grand accomplishments if you'd only think!
Yes, that does sound rather lovely.
I mean, masterful, you know, what a pleasant surprise. We're not blasting off already, are we?
The schedule remains unchanged, for better or worse. Which is why the Forum has elected to accept assistance in resolving the Etherburner conundrum.
Not seen you lot down here before.
There are Archons among their number, but engineering is not their expertise. Nevertheless, the Forum concedes the slim possibility that they may have insights to offer. If not, you are at liberty to return them to the surface, by whatever means you see fit.
I assure you that won't be necessary. Now, about your troubles with the Etherburner.
Aye, I'll walk you through it. Suppose I could do with a change of pace. As the name ought to tell you, the ether burner burns ether, ambient or otherwise, and transforms it into motive force. Think of it like a giant bomb that never stops exploding. Even out in that black void where the ether's right sparse, it's strong enough to move our arc. And it probably won't kill you like an actual bomb.
But it ain't perfect. According to my calculations, to travel to the moon and back fast enough for the Forum's liking, the conversion rate needs to be 6% more efficient. A measly 6%, you say?
But if I could have squeezed even another 0.6 out of it, don't you think I'd have built it that way in the first place?
Hast thou consulted with the Loperates? Yes, they too are conducting their own research, for lack of a ready answer. The moon's propulsion systems are considerable, naturally, yet they are commensurately massive. It is no easy feat to convert their technology into an efficient means of propulsion for a teeny tiny toy boat, as they say, and as I most certainly do not.
Yes, exactly! Damn it all, I asked for refined adamantite and they send me uppity rabbits with inscrutable, ancient, incompatible technology! You're trying to drive me mad!
Do you speak of Allegan refined adamantite, perchance?
You know of it?
Only in the most general terms, I'm afraid. 'Twas an alloy of Allegan make, but the secrets of its production were closely guarded. As I recall, the record stated it was vital to Dalamud's construction and launch.
Oi, that's the stuff. No material more conductive far as I know. Slotting some ends like blowing up a dam and watching the river of Aether come rushing through! I ain't a living soul that knows how to make it, though. We were fortunate enough to salvage some for the Aether Burner, just a wee bit, mind, from a chunk of Dalamud that came hurtling into the Northern Empty during the Calamity. With more? Well, that extra 6% efficiency will be child's play. It's a crying shame that we've no other sources.
Surely the many shards of Dalamud scattered throughout Eorzea would suffice. Why not get the refined adamantite from them?
We tried, believe you me. But only a few specialized pieces would have had any in them to begin with. Drive calls from Ragnarok class internment hulks. Those are the prize bits we really need. According to the Gleaners, getting to them means delving deep into the shards. And the defenses are still very operational and very eager to blow them up.
I see.
It's rough going in there, even for the Queen. Not sure they'd make it out alive.
Weren't we near that part of the Ragnarok when we went to destroy Bahamut? Heavens, are you all right? You look pale as a... Well, best put that battle from your mind for now. Deep breaths. That's it.
Fair enough.
There are multiple internment hulks in Eorzea alone, so handling this ourselves may not be the most efficient option. Rather, if we could salvage adamantite from the shard simultaneously... Thancred, is the link shell we established before you went to Garlemald still active?
Of course. The floor is yours.
What's all this? Gathering firewood, so to speak. We alone can accomplish little, but joined by others, we may yet build a bonfire to carry us heavensward. This is Alphano. The Scions have need of you.
Understood. I will contact the Lord Commander and dispatch our finest at once.
My sisters are somewhat preoccupied with the final days, so I will lead the Twelveswood expedition myself.
Nice.
Are you aware of any other sources of refined adamantite?
Logically, such an invaluable alloy would have been utilized solely where absolutely necessary, in components intended to conduct or collect surpassing amounts of ether. Any extant instrumentation or devices would have likely found their way into the hands of etherologists or enthusiasts.
magical artifacts of Allegan design? The Eastern Alliance will send word to one and all. Are there other ways we may offer aid? No shards of the Lesser Moon's scar are our soil, but our stake in this cause is no less for it.
Is there anything in Othard that might be of use to you?
Othard, you say? Oh, you got friends in far places, lad. Anyway, if you're offering, I wouldn't say no to one of those Far Eastern sacred relics. Some of them could hold enough ether to summon a whole damn primal. Combine a source like that with the ether burner, and 3, 2, 1, kaboom!
This guy is interesting.
I gather you heard his explosive enthusiasm. Might you secure us a suitable relic?
It shall be done. I know little of machines, but I promise we will do our utmost to gather the materials you need to finish your starship. I am glad for the work, in truth. Better to busy oneself than wait and fret over disasters foretold.
There is a solid
Then why are we all still standing about yapping? This plunder for the taking. And I'm a born plunderer. I'll be an old Charlian before you know it. Start mixing the grog!
I'm certain that can be arranged. Thank you all, and do be careful.
Just like that.
Aye, just like that. Our refined adamantite is on its way. Now let us consider our next steps, shall we? There's yet much to be done.
Yep.
Our course of action is clear. We must harvest refined adamantite from the shards of Delamud and procure arcane relics of Allegan make. Summon the best and brightest of our immortal flames, and form an expeditionary party at once. Call upon the Sultan Sworn and Brass Blades for support as you must. Papashan, send word to the guilds. We will require the expertise of master artisans if we are to have any hope of identifying and recovering these elusive materials. Theogeist, we have need of your stone torches. They are to assist the immortal flames in scouring the ruins, and to help secure the surrounding areas. I trust I can count on your support.
As commander of the Stone Torches, my son Zimberk will personally see it done.
Huh. Pippin, I would have you lead the raiding party. Assemble your finest, and with Tizona's blade, clear the way. Lord Lolorito, I pray you take charge of the search for Allegan relics. Surely you know of some being traded on open or clandestine markets, or sleeping in collectors' vaults. Of course, I ask not that you do this out of the kindness of your heart. By all means, profit on the transactions. I wish you the joy of it.
Huh.
The final days descend upon our world. If circumstances are truly as dire as they say, Uldar's best efforts may be for naught. And yet, when we Eorzeans rose from the ashes to rebuild our broken realm, did we not learn one simple truth? That which seems all but impossible to overcome alone may yet be possible if we stand together. It was the Scions who united us then, and it is the Scions who call upon us now. Uldar will answer that call. We will summon our courage and join the fight for our world's future. You know your duties. I, Nanamo Ulnamo, 17th in the line of Ul, bid you good luck and godspeed.
Right before I forget, this is from my opening section. Shroud. There is all of the links to my chat of the artists who have given me permission to use their music. Those will only be used on Starting Soon and BRB streams, just for the sake of it allows me to use my VODs on YouTube again.
We fielded a goodly number, but our ranks are heavy with healers, and an abundance of restorative magics will be of little help in destroying Dalamud's defenses. Still, it has ever been thus with Gridania. We must steel ourselves for a protracted engagement.
No, you don't.
In that case, might I suggest taking us along?
Police and the...
Commander Hext! What are you doing here?
None of the shards in Ghirabania are big enough to hold an internment hulk. So we said to ourselves, why not lend our neighbors a hand? We thought you might be short on people with a talent for breaking things.
While it pains me to admit it, you are right. Are our deficiencies so plain to see?
It might have been a lifetime ago, but I was once one of the Scions assigned to the Shroud. I know this forest well. I know your people. And I know we will be stronger if we fight this fight together.
Then I will impose upon you with a clear conscience. Come, let us speak of how to integrate our forces.
Yep. I won't let it all be for nothing. I promise you, Papalima.
There you are! We've no time to waste, brother. Everyone has already... was a roar. A dragon's roar.
My, oh my. We're on the Ruby Sea.
And so, in summation, the Eastern Alliance, as well as the Honorable Lord Lollarito himself, reached out to me for assistance in procuring these treasures of the divine, and I, in turn, do beseech the Confederacy for aid.
Tortle dude.
Is that
Hancock? What a surprise this is. And a fortuitous one at that. I have a favor to ask, you see.
He's got a solid point there. Technically, I could just fly, fast travel there, teleport, but it's not what I want to do here, honestly, just because this is saving me a little bit of money, which is actually really important. To this aetherite. Around, hopefully without getting in anyone's way, essentially. one more person that I'll have to talk to after this. I feel like it'd be somewhere back in here. Does not realize that the Loprits are hat wearing rabbits. To buying more on the line here. Thank you. can't even hear you. I'm just gonna talk to you. Water is important for fletching settlement. Cool, I get to escort some people. I get seen when I'm running away. I do not disagree that he is hilarious. Headset. Put with a wired one. Oh, I thought you could. Well, that's weird. iPhones can't have headsets plugged into them. That's what I was saying about that. What happens when you sleep with those damn things in all the time? Fair enough. Which, guess what? For too much longer, it's gonna feel like that in here. Oh no, I understand. so I can do the next thing. That is actually a question I don't have the answer to, and it does intrigue me. wonder, I'm asking you this in terms of my chat love. Which do you think came first in terms of orange? The color or the fruit? About to happen. He's about to try lemons for the first time. Second, you almost lost the weight. Thank you. nothing in this particular spot to attack me. But where have I seen the 80s? No. I'm automatically aggro on me. Since, you know, which was 9 levels difference between you and the target, and that's what makes them not charge after you. Something like that. And I'm only 2 levels over 88, so. Next. actually continue utilizing my Chocobo companion here, as by doing so, I can gain levels for him, allowing me to give him more skills. And also, it'll help me survive a little better, because I have him in healing stance. That's the stance that is the best to put him in, period, really. With the exception of if you're a healer, then tank stance or DPS stance are equally good. But that's just me. Plankrids here now. Give me just one moment, guys. I am going to be turning my camera off for now. And I gotta go disable a bunch of things over here quickly. On my channel point rewards for the moment, just because, oh word, it's way, way too hot for me to currently continue. With this shirt on, I feel like I'm dying. Alright. That being said, I say we will get back into it now. Thank you. definitely got his anxieties, and they're not all unfounded. Look at that, throwing away, toss this man something. But I can't remember if that's the actual... That's what I thought. Thank you. much faster. Because I genuinely don't know. I didn't think you would be, but... I cannot believe that dude just mentioned how they, assistants, for lack of a better phrase, were tired and hadn't slept in weeks, and he then called them lazy. This is exactly what is wrong with the world. Like, holy fuck. That is a mentality I know too many people with. So, just people around here.
Lively, isn't it? The town is abuzz. Everyone eager to meet with our friends from the
moon. So far, I have completed 3 of the 88 quests of this stream. I'm going to go on a quick BRB here.
It would behoove you to consult with Sleeping Way. As our moon's pilot, his advice should be most pertinent.
I'm impressed. Truth be told, I struggle to tell one from another. No offense intended, of course.
Taken. After you and your friends left Mare Lamentorum, we spent no small amount of time with your Urianje. Oh, the conversations we had. He told us all about Atheris, answered our every question, no matter how trifling or trivial. Look! Every page fills to the margins with knowledge. When I first arrived, I was struck by how little I knew. It was daunting, but then I realized that were it not for Urianje and his teachings, we'd still be stuck on the moon, gazing at your world and wondering what we've been missing.
James, you got a point.
What would they think if they could see Urianje now? I dare say they'd be more than a bit surprised, and impressed, no doubt. Master Louisois, Minfilia, Papalimo, and not to forget.
Oh, there. Heard there was a visiting expert who we might bother with a few questions. I take it you'd be the one.
Don't like these guys.
Yeah. Yes, I am.
Vilson and Blavida, Charlian's foremost researchers in the field of teleportation magic, and Moonbreeder's parents.
It hath been some time. Tis good to see you in good health.
Likewise, old friend. Levita and I were most honored to answer the call. Never expected this reunion, though, did we, dear?
I'll say, the nerve. Sending that letter, then running off to the gods know where. Do you have any idea how worried we were?
I'm sorry. 'Twas remiss of me not to deliver the news in person. No, more than that. 'twas I who...
Our daughter was disillusioned after Master Louisois left her behind. The day the Scions called upon her was the happiest I'd seen her in years. She made her every choice of her own free will. No one could have ever forced her to do otherwise. Don't blame yourself for her death. Celebrate her life. You know that's what she'd want.
Damn. This scene...
If there is one thing we resent you for, it was that we could not be there to mourn her with you. Reading the words you penned in that shaky hand, we must have cried as much for you as we did for her.
This is just kicking my heart in the dick. The fields.
I'm sorry. I truly, truly am.
Just came full circle from...
I knew not what to say. Knew not how to express my feelings. The poems and platitudes of wiser men, musings on sadness and loss, studied and memorized, and meaningless in the moment.
Silly boy. We are all powerless before such grief. Even now, try as I might, the words escape me. But in our hearts, we know, we always know.
I remember when you were young, how the lads teased you for choosing the company of books over others. Our moon didn't take kindly to that. Be nice to Orionje, she'd shout, and give them a walloping. No matter how many times we scolded her.
So we offered a suggestion. Rather than starting fights, why don't you be the bridge between Orionje and the others? She had to mull it over for a while, arms crossed, brow furrowed in intense thought. But from that day on, she never let you be alone. She'd drag you outside to play, pepper you with endless questions, read the same books you read, all to try and understand you that much better. I'm sure it was annoying and exhausting at the time, but she only ever had the best of intentions.
And look at you now, at the center of the crowd. The reason there even is a crowd, having brought these people together. You've no idea how proud we are.
To see the boy, our daughter trusted and believed in more than anyone, grow into the man she always knew he could be. I can see her in you too. Feel her. She walks with you wheresoever you go. So thank you, Orionje, for being who you are.
I think I can feel her too. The truth of her life, not sorrow, but hope and love.
She was important to him, wasn't she?
You could ask the man himself.
Oh, no, no. But watching this exchange reminds me how much I've yet to learn about your world and its people.
You can live here your entire life and hardly learn a thing. And that's why it's too soon for this to end.
Just a little bit. Thank you very much. Alright, back at it, everybody. Let's finish out the stream strong. Debating going ahead and ending the stream at the 2-hour mark, which will be before the 8:30 mark hits here on the East Coast. It's currently 8:10, and it's 1 hour 42 minutes 30 some seconds of stream. So let's go from there. Also take a fairly direct route there. Just for the sake of it'll definitely allow me to make it in the 3-minute time frame that I have. Oh, which also has a thank you. I do have to go here. Ain't that right? So I will start with that. Before I go past it just a little ways, speak to quest termination, and while they're at the continuation point after the conversation. So, change to the Aetherite. Turn in this quest. Tell stories. Seems to be having a grand old time. Actually pretty valid thought process there. Yeah. or the plight of those who might conceivably... Well, those one might conceivably say it is not wisdom, it is indolence. Degree, that's hilarious. We're single-minded. Spot. I think the gold will be angry. Time to go help fanboy, I mean Frahatia. This process that you're on, but it is still a pretty solid bit, and I actually will remember to go edit out the break and then immediately post it to my VOD's channel, as I am trying to start doing that again. haven't posted anything but the two interviews to it. Again. Done. I appreciate everybody that tuned in. Look forward to seeing how things are looked at later on from the VOD being posted to YouTube. I do enjoy all of that. Thank you to everybody. And I mean everybody who stopped by today. Even though you lurked or anything, it is great. For those of you in my stream, there's a Discord. I also have a Twitter, which I forgot to post to today because I don't always think things through, apparently. And I have a sponsor, which I will also link in the description of the VOD. That being said, I do need to go locate somebody for us to raid real fast. Should not take any great amount of time to find somebody here, as there's not a whole lot of people to raid in my preference for setup to raiders. So, with that being said, I know who we're raiding, and I'm going to go ahead and raid out, guys. Thank you so very much. Copy my raid message here. Anybody lurking is welcome to copy it as well. And let's go out on a raid. Thank you so very much. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.